God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the works thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe display. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When through the woods and forest glades I wander, and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees, when I look down from lofty mountain grandeur and see the blue and feel the gentle
Hello and welcome to worship this morning as we join together in the Lord's name. It's good to meet together, even if we're doing it online. And a big happy new year to you as well. I hope that 2021 promises good things for us all. As we come together in the Lord's name, some words of welcome from our booklet. The words will come up on the screen as well. Grace, mercy and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you and also with you. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. We're going to start our worship this morning with that wonderful modern song, 10,000 Reasons. Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul, I'll worship Your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul, worship His holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul, I'll worship Your holy name.
Reasons for
worship your holy name.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, indeed. Remember that we have come together in the name of Christ to offer our praise and thanksgiving, to hear and receive God's holy word, to pray for the needs of the world, and to seek the forgiveness of our sins, that by the power of the Holy Spirit, we may give ourselves to the service of God. A voice cries out in the wilderness, "Make straight the way of the Lord." So let us listen and turn to the Lord in penitence and faith. We join together in the words of the confession. Lord God, we have sinned against you. We have done evil in your sight. We are sorry and repent. Have mercy on us according to your love. Wash away our wrongdoing and cleanse us from our sin. Renew a right spirit within us and restore us to the joy of your salvation through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Hear the words of forgiveness which Christ offers to all who turn to him. May the Father of all mercies cleanse you from your sins and restore you in his image to the praise and glory of his name through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed is the Lord, for he has heard the voice of our prayer. Therefore shall our hearts dance for joy, and in our song we will praise our God. Blessed are you, sovereign God, creator of heaven and earth. To you be glory and praise forever. As your living word, eternal in heaven, assumed the frailty of our mortal flesh, may the light of your love be born in us to fill our hearts with joy as we declare, "Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever." As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, So may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. Words from Isaiah 9, as we rejoice in the gift of Christ into the world. If you'd like to join in the bold type. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in the land of deep darkness, upon them the light has dawned. You have increased their joy and given them great gladness. They rejoice before you, as with joy at the harvest. For you have shattered the yoke that burdened them, the collar that lay heavy on their shoulders. For to us a child is born, and to us a son is given. And the government will be upon his shoulders. And his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace, there will be no end. Upon the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish and uphold it with justice and righteousness. From this time forth and forevermore, the zeal of the Lord will do this. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. We're going to have our reading from the Bible, which is taken from Philippians chapter 1. And over the next few weeks, we'll be doing different parts of Paul's letter to the Philippians. And today we're thinking about the joy of growing in maturity, of being together, being united, and being strengthened in our differences.
Paul and Timothy, servants of Christ Jesus, to all God's holy people in Christ Jesus at Philippi, together with the overseers and deacons, grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I thank my God every time I remember you. In all my prayers for all of you, I always pray with joy because of your partnership in the gospel from the first day until now, being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. It is right for me to feel this way about all of you, since I have you in my heart. And whether I am in chains or defending and confirming the gospel, all of you share in God's grace with me. God can testify how I long for all of you with the affection of Christ Jesus. And this is my prayer, that your love may abound more and more in knowledge and depth of insight, so that you may be able to discern what is best and may be pure and blameless for the day of Christ, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ, to the glory and praise of God.
This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let me just say a prayer as we think about this passage together this morning. Gracious Father, as we enter into this new year, help us to appreciate each other. We give you thanks for the people that surround us, our brothers and sisters in faith. Help us to pray for each other, support each other with joy, seeking the best for each other, to spiritually grow together and to live lives that bring glory and honour to your name. Lord, as a church, we pray that you would lead us on by your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You know, looking back with joy can lift our hearts and in the present, empower us to look to the future, especially when the joy is from the Lord. I can still remember some of the young people that I've met on camps and youth groups. Sometimes I'm still friends, inverted commas, with them on Facebook and things like that. I see them going on with the Lord, which is wonderful to see. Some of them actually leading camps themselves, which was great to hear about that a couple of years ago. And it leads my heart to pray for them and encourage them. I know that there will be times in the future when we will be able to do God's work in the way that we used to do it. And Paul was in a similar boat. He was suffering under house arrest in Rome, unable to leave the home, his home that he had there, and dependent on others. Sounds familiar these days, doesn't it? What we're going to think about today, we're going to be thinking about the joy that there is. The joy that is found in this epistle. That Paul writes, even though despite his circumstances, he writes with real joy. A joy that we can share in as well this day. Joy from different people coming together. And we get that in verse 3 from the reading. He's given this introduction, hasn't he? About who he is and who's with him. And then he goes on and speaks about this great joy within him. The joy of the different people. When he wrote this letter, he wrote it to encourage and bless them. He looked back with joy at the people he'd met there. Remember in Acts 16, there was stories of how God had worked and done wonderful things in Philippi. Maybe Paul had remembered some of those people he'd been in contact with. Acts 16, as I said, described some of them. There was the wealthy dealer in purple cloth, Lydia, the first recorded European convert, who opened her home up to the believers so that they could meet there. There was the slave girl who was possessed, and her owners made money out of her by being able to tell fortunes. She followed Paul and Silas around and telling everyone that they should listen to them. It got really annoying, and eventually Paul exercised the Spirit by the power of Jesus. And then there was the jailer, converted by the miraculous non-escape of Paul and Silas, as the doors of the prison were shook open and the chains of the prisoners, the fetters were broken. But they didn't know, nobody escaped. This was a place where God was at work, and the jailer was converted. A place, as Paul was dictating the letter, maybe he had a little wistful look in his eye as he was thinking about these people, so different, these wonderful people. The letter was for them. It was his word of encouragement and blessing. And just notice how different these folk were. But the joyful expression of the Christian faith was cutting barriers that were in society. The girl, a slave, the rough jailer, a man and his family, the refined, successful businesswoman, all members of the same church, which had flourished in that small city. These people normally would never have mixed, would they? But the power of the gospel is for all people, and their stories, individually but collectively, are an example to us as well. At our men's group, we used to run in Weaverham. We used to go for an occasional curry together. Tony, one of the men there, a very interesting chap. He could tell a story or two, I tell you. He was very funny. And he sold agricultural equipment. And he said he loved coming on these curry nights. He certainly did like his food. But he loved coming on these curry nights. And he met up with all sorts of different people. Mainly in his life, he dealt with farmers and farm machinery workers. But there was all these people, the banker, the bus driver, the businessman, the chemist, the biker, the nuclear plant decommissioner, all together. And that's a part of the joy, isn't it, of being a Christian, is that we meet up with folk from all strands of life. But we have that common faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Joy in the different people. Joy, secondly, in the joy, join in the joy of partnership. Join in the joy of partnership. Paul prayed with joy not only for these very different folk together, but also as they were in partnership with him and each other in the gospel. And God was going to continue that good work until it was completed. They were pulling together in the same different direction. Yes, they were very different, but they were all going the same way. Some commentators have noticed that the word all occurs so many times in the letter. And we also have this word partner together as well. They were all in it together. Paul in his room, his house arrest in Rome, But also on top of that, there was all these different people, all in it together, all in this gospel partnership. Paul watered them, being together in the work of God. He feels this joy for them all, verse 7. They're all in his heart, all in his heart. They all share the spreading of the gospel, the good news of Jesus. He longs for all of them with the affection of Christ, verse 8. In that section, we get all. It's so important that they're all together. And when a church is pulling together, going in the direction God is going to call us to, it's a powerful thing for us locally in Shevington. What does it mean? And there's a call for unity, working together in the Lord. As we enter 2021, it's good to be pulling together, isn't it? And to be going in God's ways. That means personally, yeah, but also corporately as a body, we go in the direction God is calling us to. Keep close to the Lord in prayer, and this will be a part of that. Meet up with others on phone, on screen, or whatever, but keep supporting each other. When we were in London, the church we were placed at was very united in Barnet. Barnet's a funny little place in London in many ways. It feels like a northern town, even despite being less than 10 miles from the middle of London. But they all had this desire to share the message they received. From the very discreet member of the House of Lords, you wouldn't have known it, and the retired milkman. All sorts of people, all pulling in the same direction. All. It's so important to be together, isn't it? And I do feel like unity here in Shevington as a church at St. Anne's, but I also feel increasingly a leading of God's Spirit as a people of God here. Let's be on our knees praying for our church to be increasingly united, but also directed by God's Holy Spirit as well. The great joy in being led into his activity. Join in the joy of partnership. Finally, receive the joy of Christian maturity, verses 9 to 11. Outside the vicarage, there are some oak trees. A tree surgeon was actually doing some work on them recently, not on ours, but the ones in the rest of the old vicarage gardens. Handsome things they were, handsome, mature trees. This tree surgeon, as most tree surgeons are that I've come across, really love what they work on. They really love trees. And he was saying how these were fine examples. I said, yes, they are. They're very mature trees. They produce two big green wheelie bins of acorns every year, which are very heavy. We have to shift them away over a couple of weeks from the front of our garden. Maturity is great, isn't it? It's great to see. It's sad to see when things are stunted and not living up to their potential. And the Christian, again, is called to maturity. It doesn't come instantly, because that doesn't happen, does it? It grows and develops over time. And in it, there is great joy. The Christian church as well is also called to that maturity. Maturity has been given a bit of a bad name at times. It's sometimes a code word for brown-suited, overcautious dullness. But that's not the description we have here. Not at all. Paul expresses his deep desire for the Philippians to move on in the faith and be led by God. What does he call for? Love abounding in verse 9. Yes, that's affection within the church, but also it's sacrificial service as well for each other. This springs from knowledge and insight. Again, all these things are the work of the Holy Spirit in the church. I can't count the number of times Christian men and women have felt moved to help and serve each other. A brother or sister in the faith serve the community in some way. They get a little niggle in their head, don't they? It's like the prompting of the Spirit just going after us, that they have to do something about it. A friend in need, a face that comes to mind who needs a phone call, an action of care for another. Part of Christian maturity is that serving each other and our community. Another aspect he describes there is righteous living. This is not just a sort of a false piety, but bearing fruit for Jesus. It's not just about not doing the bad stuff, as it were, the actions and attitude that God doesn't want. Yes, those things are not worthy of the believer to be cast away. But he also speaks about putting on actions and attitudes, desires, bearing fruit for Jesus. And when we know we are on God's way, as a Christian, it gives us great joy, contentment in our heart. It may not be easy, but a contentment in knowing that we are going God's way. And again, sometimes it works against the works of the world or the works of the flesh. It's hard work in growing in maturity, but there is great joy and contentment there. And as the church reflects this maturity, it becomes a beacon of praise. A mature tree reflects the creative power of its creator, of the power of God. A mature church reflects the power of the Holy Spirit, of God, the Spirit of Jesus, as he's at work in the hearts of the believers there. All together. Different, but all together. Let's be those people who seek God's leading, prepared to put off our own desires and to follow the way God wants us to go. To finish, how do we accomplish this? Paul, in all his letters, sees the spiritual life of the church as the most prime importance. I think that's completely true. Our walk with the Lord is so important. Our openness to the leading of God's Spirit in maturity, a mark of that maturity itself. Our response is saying day by day, yes, Lord, lead me on today. Direct my thoughts. May I be open to your prompting and leading, to your praise and glory. May I grow in love and knowledge and holiness and purity. May I put on those things which you call me to and get rid of the things that are not worthy. And you know, as we come to him and say these things more and more, as we dig into his word, as we come to him in prayer, this joyful, united, unified, loving, holy living church is a great, wonderful witness to the power of God in the world. Let's be open to Jesus. Let's be open to his leading in 2021 and the wonderful joy that comes from being together and being his people. Let me say a prayer. This day, this year, Lord, we want to experience the joy that is being one of the many and varied people who call you Lord. We open ourselves up to your leading, Lord Jesus. And we ask that your Holy Spirit would come into our hearts and minds and direct our paths. Lord, as a church, may we live the life that you want us to, according to your will and purposes, to your praise and glory. Amen. In response, we're going to have a lovely, great hymn. Oh, for a thousand tongues to sing my great Redeemer's praise. And great to sing such a powerful, wonderful hymn. We're going to join together in the words of the Creed. The words will come up on the screen together. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We join together in the prayers for our world, for our country, for our church, for our community, and for those in need. Let us pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we pray for your world. Pray for the leaders of the world at this time of trouble. Lord, that you would bring peace. We pray against those who do want to bring bloodshed and violence to streets of different countries. We pray that your peace would reign in our world, Lord God. We pray for those who are in need, that you would supply their needs with food or water, whatever it may be, medical supplies. Heavenly Father, aid those who are seeking to bring comfort and deliverance to those in need around our world. And Lord God, we pray for the leaders that they would have wisdom to make the right decisions in these difficult times. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Heavenly Father, we pray your blessing upon our Queen. Lord, continue to lead her on in this coming year. Bless her mightily and the rest of the royal family. Strengthen them, Lord. And we pray for the Queen and her own faith. Lord, may she be one who shares what she believes with her country. Pray for our Prime Minister that you give him wisdom in the dreadfully difficult decisions which are made and the different voices which must be calling upon him. Lord, strengthen our nation at these tough times. We pray for your protection on many against this disease, COVID, and we pray, Lord God, our country would be wise in its actions. Strengthen us, Lord God, as a nation. And we pray for the vaccinations which are going out into the arms of many people. Lord, we pray that they would be effective, and Lord, that this disease would be cast back at this time, we pray. And Lord, by your Holy Spirit, give people who are suffering in the troubles of this time, the loneliness which is felt. Lord, we pray that you would lift their hearts and strengthen them. For our nation, we pray for an outpouring of your Spirit at this time. And Lord, that people would find solace and strength in you, Lord God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Pray for our bishops, remembering Bishops Julian and Philip and Jill, that they may be diligent in prayer, in study of your word, in fellowship. Uphold them, we pray, Lord God. Pray for all Christian leaders that would be faithful to the proclamation of the good news of Jesus in our communities. May you, by word and example, we share that wonderful message we have. Pray for all Christian people, that we be faithful in service and in seeking you, Lord God, in our lives. And though we be different from different parts of community and society, may we reflect the Lord Jesus Christ in our lives and be united in service. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We pray for an outpouring of your Spirit, Lord Jesus, upon our community, that many would turn to you again. We pray for the people of our streets, our neighbours, friends, those people locally. Again, we pray for protection upon those who are weak and vulnerable at this time. We pray also that people would use their strength for your honour and glory and for the service of other people. Pray for the work of the pantry, Lord, as it continues and seeks to alleviate hunger, but also to be good stewards of what you have given us, Lord God. And we pray for the children of our community as they, many of them are learning at home and the different stresses and strains that puts on family life. Lord, we do pray for a sense of your peace upon our communities, Lord God, and the children in their education at this time. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Pray for those going through a time of sickness, mind, body or spirit, and in the silence we lift to the Lord those known to ourselves who need his special touch at this time. Heavenly Father, we pray that you draw close to those who are going through that time of sickness or injury, of distress in mind, body or spirit. Lord, we pray your healing presence would be upon them and that you would bring them your peace at this time. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Pray for those who've lost loved ones over recent weeks. Pray for the families who have lost loved ones over the Christmas period and how difficult that is. Draw close to those who mourn, we pray, Lord Jesus. Bring them the hope that there is in the resurrection. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. The collect or the special prayer for this, the 17th of January. Almighty God, in Christ you make all things new. Transform the poverty of our nature by the riches of your grace. And in the renewal of our lives, make known your heavenly glory. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Gathering our prayers and praises into one, let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Shall we share the grace with one another? And as we think about the difference that there is in the people of our church, but also know that the unity that we have in the Lord Jesus Christ, we join together in the words of the grace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, evermore. Amen. A final song, which is based on all those old lang syne. Nearly didn't be able to say that. Old lang syne. As we enter into 2021. It speaks about that unity of going forward together.
Your grace will never be forgot, your mercy all my life will be my soul's forever song. my story and my highlight. From mountaintop to valley low, through laughter and through tears, surely the goodness of my God will follow all the years. For all that you have done for us, for every battle won, we'll raise a song to bless your heart for all that you have done. In all our failures and regrets, you've always led us home. Redemption's arm has raised us up, our triumph in the storm. For all that you have done for us, for every battle won, we'll raise a song to bless your heart.